美国在人民权运动之后呢，废除了学校的种族隔离制度，然后实际上就让有才能的黑人学生可以进入好的中学，另外呢，以这政策优惠呢，进入像哈佛这样的名校，这样的话就实际上是提高了黑人这样一些有才能的年轻人呢，给他们进入上层社会，能够为自己本族群去发言，争取利益的话呢，是一个象征。
And I have a positive example actually from my own class right now. I think I have 80 students and it's extremely diverse. I have a lot of students from China. I have 10 of them, but I also have 11 African American students. I have 7 Muslim American students. And somehow I set the rules. I think leadership is important. I said, look, we are going to have a conversation.And if somebody says something that bothers you, your reaction won't be just to be angry. You have to express what it is that bothered you, and then we will go back and forth and have a conversation. And I was so surprised. It's extremely successful in such a different and diverse class, and then almost like creating the channels for listening and communication.
实际上我看到的是在苏世民书院。这个有是国际学生，他们到这个苏世民书院来学习一年以后呢，已经打破了原来的这种我们想象界限。他学完以后，他可能还回到他自己国家，他看到这个地方的发展机会，愿意在这来发展。而且更好的话，不同国家同学们之间啊，他们互相一起来商讨，哎，有些什么样的新的好的发展机会，这个可能的话呢，是我们今后我们特别能希望能看到的各个国家的年轻人。能够在一起学习，一起成长，一起去创业，一起去解决我们人类面临的问题。